I go round to see Len every now and then at number 28, Bilton Grange Estate, round about 2:30 on a Tuesday afternoon. He's got some jobs for me and a builder's cup of tea. I pot up his plants and I set his bedding out. I was trimming his edge when I found out about Len's lion. Len's lion. On the roof above his door, he stood about 4'4". That lion must come down. But he weighs 200 pounds. Get the ladder from the shed. That lion must be fed. If we get him off the roof, we'll soon find out the truth. Well, we pushed and we tugged and we shugged and we hauled away. No matter what he did, he clearly wants to stay. Len's lion. Len's lion. Called up a couple of boys, handy with such toys, with tackle and some rope. Me shoulder it nearly broke. That lion weighed a ton. Carrying him was no fun, so we set him on the floor just by Len's back door. He stood and he stared and he frowned and he scratched his head. He's no good there, you'll have to put him back, he said. Len's lion. Len's lion. If you take a lion down, you better leave him on the ground. My advice to you, you better take him to a zoo. If he's marble and he's white, never leave him above head height. That's what I said to Len. I remind him now and then. To get him up there, you must have had some luck. He said he knew a rasta with a forklift truck. Len's lion. Len's lion. Len's lion. Len's lion. Len's lion.